Seating is 5-passenger vehicle. Driver and passenger have 8-way power adjustments with 2-way lumbar. Standard seating is deluxe interior. It's available in 2 colors, black and Stratus gray. And then available luxury. We have leather available in the premium package and luxury package. 60-40 split folding rear seats, but it does retain the 40-20-40, so that center portion can be manually barred down. For those that want to, you know, with kids that have sporting goods equipment, or you know, somebody throws a 2x4 in the back of an RX, which I dare not think they would do, but again, it's all about utility. It's a sport utility vehicle. But with the power fold or manual fold, it's 60-40 split. Controls are on the right side of the rear cargo area, as well as on each side of the seats and drive on the passenger, the rear seats left and right, as well as the driver's front seat to control that. So the interior trim finishes, standard is the striated black trim. Available with premium package, we offer 3. So we have the espresso walnut, matte bamboo, and a matte linear dark mocha wood, so very rich interior palette. With this, would be regular leather interior. Luxury package has its unique trim, which is a gray sapele wood with aluminum. And the Yamaha is who we use with our interior trim pieces. We have since day one with Lexus and continue that partnership. They will also be at the Colonies Market. We'll get a chance to see how this, especially this gray sapele wood trim has been developed. It makes use of a layer of wood underneath. Underneath it is a layer of aluminum, and then by way of lasers, they actually etch these lines in there. So in a sense, it kind of blends old world tradition of wood with a modern look and feel. And this is a close-up shot of it, but really doesn't do justice until you see it in person. So again, that's part of the luxury package. Storage abounds with inside the RX. We have seen the trend for return of the sunglasses. For those of us that like the place to put our sunglasses in the overhead console area, we have that. As well as underneath the HVAC system is a large center box area. We have 2 cup holders with an adjustable front cup holder, actually. And there's a shot a little bit later, but you can actually fit those very tall drinks. The bottom of that front cup holder actually goes down, so it allows for a larger and more secure housing of the drink. Also, the palm rest box, so where the remote touch is, that actually flips open. So whether it's remote touch or the Lexus display audio controller, you can actually store something like a smartphone or a media player within there. And then the center console features 2 USB ports, aux cable, and 12-volt power. And right-hand side of the center console, the picture doesn't do it justice. There's actually a pocket there that actually allows storage of not like an iPad mini or something of that nature. So the meter display on the RX350 is this, featuring 4 rings illuminated, surrounded by aluminum trim. RX458 is very similar, but again, we have a power meter that if we put in sport mode, we just replace it with a tachometer. Both of them feature a 4.2-inch thin-film transistor multi-information display. You've seen this in several of our other vehicles, so we've been with some of our Lexus events. Provides information such as audio, phone information, miles per gallon, and things of that nature. Standard is an 8-inch multi-display, so this would be basically a non-nav unit, as you see here. So the front and center, again, reducing the need for a driver to look away from the straight ahead. You would control it with a display audio controller, so this rotary knob allows you to cycle through climate, audio, phone, things of that nature. And this is a good shot of the cup holder. You can see that in between, there's that little says push. So if we have pushed down already in the cup holder, we can actually hit the push button, and that would actually raise the lower level up again to get it back to its normal. One of the unique things, or things that I think is really cool, just something simple. Also, it's a very grippy material, the rubber at the base of those cup holders, so it allows for one-handed operation of a water bottle. And I said water. My Jersey accent comes out every so often. Remote touch interface is with navigation. There's been enhancements. So the RX was the first vehicle that we offered the remote touch interface. We have seen the return of the enter buttons on each side. Consumers requested that So the 8-inch display I showed you is available with navigation as well. As Ryan mentioned, there is a 12.3-inch, and there's a close-up shot of that, so you can see the enter buttons on each side and the return key. So the 12.3-inch multi-information display is quite impressive. It's actually the same size as what we offer in the GS and the LS, but in those vehicles, you were limited. You could only have about two-thirds of the display showing the navigation. The other portion would always show climate control or audio, things of that nature, like this. But the guest can actually now make a full screen. So quite impressive. The design is a hoodless design for the display itself. So it's very kind of a focal point inside the vehicle. Tomorrow, be sure to grab me so I can kind of show you how to cycle through going full screen to regular. Also, on the right-hand side, you can see several icons there. They are shortcuts for things like audio, climate control, fuel economy and such, allowing guests easier to get in and out, kind of get some information quickly at their fingertips. For those wanting information right in front, we do now offer available heads-up display. It has a larger screen size, it's up 362%, and it's colored, and basically allows for varying levels of information. At the bottom is just showing minimum display miles per hour, and then you can increase it all the way up with additional information, which would feature things like some of the safety system, lane keep assist information, navigation, turn-by-turn directions, and such. So we have some vehicles that you'll be able to experience that tomorrow. The steering wheel is a three-spoke steering wheel, LFA and Aspire. On the left-hand side, we have our traditional audio, phone, and voice recognition capabilities. And the right features a multi-information display toggle, as well as it's equipped with lane keep assist or dynamic radar. One thing too, for those that are Apple phone users, we do of course offer Series Eyes Free as well within the vehicle standard. So automatic climate control, dual zone climate control. It does feature S-Flow, which we've introduced on several of our other vehicles. That basically allows control of the air conditioning or heating so that it's directed to the occupant that's in the vehicle. If it's solely in one person driving, why have air kind of going to the passenger or seat area? You can then cycle through and then increase that flow to other when there's more people than one. A nice enhancement has been the addition of climate concierge, which is kind of a set it and forget it. If you have automatic climate control turned on, using the heated or ventilated seats, first time you hit one of those buttons, it'll illuminate auto. So in that case, not only the ambient temperature within the cabin, but the seat heating or ventilation will actually be controlled. So again, set it and forget it, let the climate concierge take care of it. And that's also shown. You can see the electric parking brake going there.